It's going to be Vinyasa Yoga. It's a flow yoga, and it's going to be taken by Ajayji Murukar. So Ajayji, I'll pass over to you.
Okay, namaste everyone. So yeah, we are starting with Vinyasa flow, but then as whenever we start with any physical activity, we just, you know, have to loosening up our joints, then raise the pulse and dynamic stretching, and we'll do some Surya Namaskars before actually we start anything. So make sure if you have any health problem, you take care of yourself and, you know, listen to your body, and don't overdo anything. If you have any backache problem, don't bend forward. If you have hernia problem, don't go back. Okay, just try to do as much as you can. So we'll just start slowly with our loosening of our joints. So we'll start with neck. So rotate neck slowly, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, change the direction, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, out, shoulders back, breathing in and out. Forward, arms forward. When your chest is expanding, breathing in, and when chest contracting, breathe out. Backward. Put hands on your shoulder and take it forward slowly and backward. Other way around. We'll do our best. So go sideways. Hands on your knees or above your knees on your thighs. Rotate in clockwise, anti-clockwise. You can do in like circle as well together. Now other way around. Now we'll just do ankles. So rotate your ankles. Change the direction. Change leg. Change direction. Yeah, just loose up your. Okay, so now our muscles are loosened up, joints are loosened up. We'll just try to do pulse raiser. So just start jogging slowly. Breathe in, breathe out. You can move your arms as well. Jump. Again, jogging. Knees up. Toes back. Keep jumping. We'll do star jump. Normal star jump first. Okay, we'll do Satat Yoga quickly. Okay, so Satat Yoga, everybody knows, we start with left arm 16 times, right arm 16 times, both arms 16 times, clap 16 times, and combination of all of this. And in between, we stop for four count, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Satat Yoga, Yoga Sthiti. Satat Yoga Kuru. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Left, right, both, clap. Left, right, both, clap. Now we'll just do deep breathing in. And breathe out, go down. Breathe in, come up. Your hands up, hold on your toes and breathe out. One more time, deep breathe in. Breathe out, go down. Breathe in, come up. And breathe out. We'll start with dynamic stretching, but we'll do some breathing as well. So hands up and breathing in. down, breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And sit. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. We'll do next stretching up, down, left, right. Spread your legs and we'll do this 8 times. When you go down, make sure you look up on your other arm. Ek, two, teen, char, paanch, chhe, saat, aath. We'll do lunges. So you come forward like this, then change the leg and stretch. We'll do 4 times. Ek, do, teen, and char. We'll do squats quickly, maybe 8. Ek, do, teen, char, and paanch, chhe, saat, aath. We'll just try to stretch our, you know, bottom part of the back part of your thighs, our knees. So back leg bent and front leg, keep it straight. Try to hold your toe and stretch. Badal, other leg forward. Now bend front leg and stretch back leg. Keep back leg straight. Change leg. Okay, I think that's enough of stretching. We'll start with Surya Namaskar. We will do maybe 3 or 4 Surya Namaskar. Okay, so everybody, Surya Namaskar Sthiti. Ek, two, teen. I'll say the mantra and I'll start. You also start the mantra with me only. Om Mitraya Namaha. And you breathe out after the mantra. Ek, breathe in. Go up. Look at your palms joining. Do, slowly come down. Breathing out. Try to touch the floor and head towards the knee. Teen, left leg back. Make sure your left knee is touching the floor. Look up. You should feel stretch on your lower back. Char, Chaturanga Dandasan. It should be straight. No hump like this. Keep it straight and look in front. Not down, not up. Look in front. Paanch, go down. Forehead, chest and knees touching the floor and hold your breath. Che, breathe in and come up. Your waist should be between your arms. Saat, go back all the way. Your toe, heels and entire toe touching the floor. Chin touching your neck. And try to look from your groin. There shouldn't be any space, but try to look there. And stretch on your shoulder as well. And go back. Aath, take left leg forward. It should be between, in the same line with your arms. Look up and stretch on your lower back. Now, keep your knees straight. Try to hold the floor, touch the floor. Hold your calf and pull inside. And thus, Namaskar Sthiti. Now, next one we'll do a bit faster. Maybe we'll hold for less time. Om Ravaye Namaha. Ek, breathe in. Do, breathe out. Then right leg back, breathe in. Char, breathe out. Paanch, hold your breath. Chhe, breathe in. Saat, breathe out. Aath, breathe in, right leg forward. Now, breathe in, breathe out, and thus breathe in, and then normal, breathe in, breathe out. We'll do two more. Om Ravaye Namaha. Guru, ek. Do, go down. Teen, left leg back. Ek pada prasanasan. Char, Chaturanga Dandasan. Paanch, Ashtangasan. Che, Bhujangasan, Cobra. Sat, Swanasan, Adomukha Swanasan. Aat, Ek pada prasanasan. Now, Uttanasan. Or Padastasan. Thus, Namaskarasan. Okay, last one we'll do a bit faster, means maybe 2 seconds for each pose. Om Suryaya Namaha. Guru, ek, do, teen, char, paanch, che, saat, aath, nau, das. Rama, ek, do, teen, swastha. The speed of the Surya Namaskar depends on how flexible you are, how regular you are. Ideally, 2 to 3 seconds you can stop between each position. So that's our body is warmed up, stretched and properly. We are going to do Vinyasa flow. Vinyasa flow is basically, we do multiple asanas in one flow. Surya Namaskar also is flow yoga only, but that accept Vinyasa flow. There can be different flow yogas. Today we'll try to do 2 standing ones in Samasthiti and 1 on Chaturanga Nadasana if time permits. So everybody in Samasthiti. Samasthiti is your leg joint and palms open on your side. So we'll be doing first Tadasana, simple, but make sure your arms go all the way from sides, not like shortcut, okay? So slowly take your arms up, up, up and join. Now pull it up completely. You should feel a stretch on your shoulder joints and arms, like you are, you know, hanged to a rope and some you are just hanging. So you should feel that stretch. The more you stay in this position, you should feel it. So this is Tadasana, palm tree. Slowly come back to Namaskarasana, breathing out. Once you are coming in the position, you can breathe in or breathe out. And once you are in that position, make sure you normally do the breathing in and breathing out naturally. So we are back into Namaskarasana. Now we are going to do Dhruvasana with right leg. So Dhruvasana, maybe you can take support from your hand and keep your heels close to your groin. If you can't, you can do here on your toe, ankle, on your calf, on your knee. But ideal position is your groin. And then Namaskar. So this is Dhruvasana. Normal, basically concentrate on your nose tip. So this is very good for balancing and concentration. So next one is Ardha Utkatasana. So half chair position. So take your support, keep it on your knees and Namaskar. So this is Ardha Utkatasana. Now we'll go back to again Dhruvasana. Same. Take support of your hand if you want to. Keep it on your groin, near your groin. Dhruvasana. Now we'll go to Vrikshasana, slowly breathing in. That's it. Then keep your legs down slowly. Back to Tadasana and back to Samasthiti. Now we'll repeat this sequence on other side. Go back to Tadasana slowly. Breathing in, pull up, lift up like somebody is, you know, hanged you on your palms, joining together. Back to Namaskarasana. Now we'll do left leg, Dhruvasana. Take support with your hand, keep it in your groin. And Dhruvasana, look at your nose tip. Normal, breathe in, breathe out. Now we'll do Vrukshasana. So hands up, slowly breathing in. Hands near your arms, near your ears. Look straight on, concentrate on your nose tip. Breathing in, breathing out slowly. Back to Namaskarasana, Dhruvasana for Namaskar, and then legs down and hands down. So this set, if you do multiple times, it becomes power yoga. So if you continue the Vinyasa flow in multiple sets, so that becomes power yoga, because then, you know, you are giving exercise to your same muscles multiple times. It's same like that we do, you know, in gym, multiple sets. So yoga in flow, if you are doing in multiple sets at home, you can do the same, repeat 2-3 times as well. But we'll move to the next sequence. If we get time, we'll come back again. So next one is Virbhadrasana sequence. So basically, I'll try to be in 45 degree so that you can see me as well. While doing this, make sure you are facing the screen. You don't stay sideways. If possible, make sure you are facing the screen so that you can see what I'm doing. So we'll go to the Utkatasana, the full chair pose, but we'll keep arms joined, okay? So slowly, arms up, join together, breathing in, and then go down, breathe out. This is the Utkatasana. This can be with palms joined or palms on the side. There are various variations as well. We are doing with palms joined this time. Now slowly take your right leg back. Keep it, your heels up, like you can see my heels. Don't keep it down, but your back leg should be straight. Your front leg should be, you know, 90 degree, close to 90 degree, arms up. This is Anjaneya Asana or Crescent Moon. Here you can bend back as well. Come back, make sure your heels is up. Now we'll move to Virbhadrasana Prakar 1, Warrior Position 1. So here we just make sure your toe is on the floor now completely, and the front leg is basically 90 degree. So 90 degree between the two leg, the direction. Rest position remains same. Namaskar and up. So this is Warrior 1. Be in that position for some time. Now slowly take your right hand back, left hand down. Down means parallel to the floor in your shoulder level. Ideally, you should look for a first front and then just tilt your neck back. You shouldn't be doing like this. This is wrong. Your chest should be in that direction and look straight on your middle finger of your front hand, left hand, and then neck, just tilt it like this. So this is Warrior 2, Virbhadrasana Prakar 2. Now we'll do Reverse Warrior. So left hand, palms up, take it back, right hand on your right knee, and look up on your left hand, middle finger. Now we'll do the windmill and go to Parivruta Parshvakonasana, revolving side angle pose. So your right hand, or the basically right hand on the other side, inside of your left leg, not here. This is the regular Parshvakonasana. We are doing revolving. So it's your chest is coming out from your thighs. Look up. Stay in this position. Now go back to Virbhadrasana Prakar 2. Now Warrior 1, Virbhadrasana 1. See, leg position changes. Now it's normal. Now we'll do Anjaneya Asana, half crescent moon. Go back. Come forward. I know you are the left leg must be hurting a lot. If it's hurting, you can just stand up for a bit and stand down again. So maybe you can stand up for a bit. So this is one sequence we did on left leg. Now we'll do other leg. So again, Samasthiti. And we'll go to Utkatasan. Hands up, breathing in. Go down, breathe out. It should be as down as you can, 90 degree up to. Now left leg, take it back this time. Keep your left heel up. Your chest facing front, hands up, and bend backward, Anjaneyasan. Come up, Virbhadrasan Prakarek. Complete feet on the floor, your heels, your toe, your sole, look front, hands up, Virbhadrasan Prakarek. Now in dough, again, right hand in front, left hand back, your neck only tilting onto right side, concentrate on your middle finger. Pull your both arms from both direction, like two people or it's somebody is pulling from both the sides. Now your palm up or the front hand, go back, reverse warrior, look up towards your finger, middle finger of your right hand. Normal breathing without, keep doing that. Now again, windmill and Parivruta Parshvakonasan, left hand near your right leg, inside, not backside, front basically. And look up on the right arm. Normal breathing without. Back to Virbhadrasan Prakar Do. Warrior Ek, Virbhadrasan Prakar Ek. Then Crescent Moon, Anjaneyasan. Utkatasan, come forward. And then stand up and Samasthiti. I'm sure if you have done all this without stopping, you must be getting lots of stretch or pressure on the knees, on the thighs, on the calf. So this basically concentrate on your feet, thighs. At the same time, your shoulders as well. So this is very good. If you do this 4 times, like 8 times total together, I'm sure that will be good enough for your shoulders and thighs and knees. Next one, before we move on to next one, we'll just go to goddess pose. So goddess pose is basically around 2 shoulders width and hands up straight, breathing in and breathe in and hands side. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. One more time, breathe in, breathe out. So in between your yogasana, try to do proper breathe in, breathe out activity as well. There are different ways, you can choose which one you want to do. Next one, we'll move on to Chaturanga. Chaturanga Dandasana is Surya Namaskar, position 4. But you can be on your knees now while you are listening and resting basically. So we are going to do some activities with your arms and some feet as well. So we'll start with left so that you can see me, my left side. Then we'll move on to right. So everybody, Chaturanga Dandasana is a plank position. There are different variations in plank. We do normally on wrist as well, but we are doing proper Chaturanga Dandasana. Now here, lift your left leg up. Keep it straight, don't keep it up. Because this is Chaturanga Dandasana, we shouldn't be taking it all the way up. If you are doing this one, Svanasana, then we take it up. So if you are in this position, Chaturanga, keep it parallel to your body. in line with your body and parallel to the floor. Now we'll do a push-up. So go down, chin and chest touching the floor. Come up. Be in the same position. Left leg touching the left elbow. Go back. Keep it up. Left leg in the middle between your arms. Back. Now left leg to your right elbow. Back. Keep it up only. We are doing Superman. So right arm up, left leg up. Keep hold this position. Now back. Now tilt to your side. Left leg on right leg, entire toe. You should be on your right arm. Make sure if you can't do this, you can take support of your knees and keep leg down. You can take support, it's okay. This is variation. You can try this way. So your left leg on your right leg and then left arm up, side plank. If you can, take your left leg up. Hold, back, back, go down. Come back to cat cow position while I'm explaining. So this side plank can be done in this way. There are different variations. Depending upon your arm strength, your leg strength, you can decide which one you want to do. Now next one we'll do other side. Go back to Chaturanga Dandasan. Make sure you're breathing in, breathing out. Right leg up. Keep it parallel to the floor. We'll do push-up. Your chin and chest on the floor. Come up. Right leg to your right elbow. Back. Right leg between your arms. Back. Right leg to left elbow. Back. Now Superman. Left arm up. Hold down. Now right leg on left to feet completely. Your body weight in this. Again, take help of your left knee if you want to. Don't hurt yourself. So back to this. Your right arm up. Take left, right leg up if you can. Side plank. Down. Down. On your knees. So this is basically different. We can do this in multiple times. The same one can be done 2-3 times to get more benefit out of it. We'll just quickly go into Ekapada Kapotasan, the pigeon pose, to gain all the energy that we already consumed for this yoga activity. So we'll to go into that position, come Ekapada Prasannasan, Surya Namaskar 3. Your right leg down. It can be in parallel with your mat. So 90 degree basically. Here, now take it with 45 degree again. Go down your chest on your thighs. Your arms stretch up. And your wrist, both wrists on the floor. Forehead on the floor. And breathe in, breathe out. Your right heel touching your left thigh. Your left leg completely straight. Then your right thigh, which is in front, is in line with your chest, is touching your limbs. So this is very good to gain energy back, breathing in, breathing out. Slowly come up. Back to Ekapada Prasannasana. Go back and change leg. Left leg in front. Take it down. This is the original position is 90 degree and then you do stretch. But we are going to do relax. So make it 45 degree. So the heel of the leg touching your thighs. Again go down. Your thighs touching your chest. ribs, hands stretch in front, wrist on the floor, forehead on the floor, breathing in, breathing out, relax. Slowly come up. Now we'll do last one for the relaxation. Is Balasan, child pose. Go on to Vajrasan and then spread your knees, shoulder width roughly. Your toes, big toes touching each other. Straight, breathing in and breathe out and go down. Your wrist on the floor from elbow to your palms. Forehead touching the floor, breathing, breathe out. This is also very good to regain the energy. You will feel refreshed. Come back up in Vajrasana. So today we did, I think, more than 16 asanas. All together, and in multiples of it, at least we did, I think, 50 times all of them. So in 20 minutes, this can be done, you know, slow or fast, depending upon your physical strength and other things. And in multiple sessions as well, you can concentrate on. If you want, I can send out to you the sequence as well, because you know it's difficult to remember. So that if you want, you know, message me or ask Mitaji, he will give you my details. So we'll finish with last one, my favorite one, which is very good to, you know, basically get the energy back. You might be feeling down as well with lots of, you know, exercise that we did. So spread your legs, your palms, hands near your knees, and come up, take your tongue out, Sihasan, and then roar. Roar, then come back on your knees, massage your neck. That's it. I think, yeah, it was Miteji.
Thank you, Ajayji.